Stawell is about a three-hour drive from Melbourne and is best known for its famous foot race, the Stawell Gift, and for gold, which it's been mining since the 1850s. Now, it could soon be famous for solving one of the biggest mysteries in the universe.
1,000 meters below me, in a disused part of this active gold mine, the Stawell Underground Physics Laboratory is being built. Down there, researchers from the ARC Center of Excellence for Dark Matter Particle Physics are trying to directly detect dark matter, something we know is out there, but have never found.
Dark matter is an invisible particle. There's five times more of it than all the atoms in all the planets, stars, and galaxies in the universe combined. It's the reason we are here. The gravity it creates holds our galaxy together, which is how we know it's there. And we pass through it every single day.
We know where it is, we know how much there is, but we still don't know exactly what it is.
As a chief investigator and member of the dark matter team, I'll need to take a journey into the Earth to our lab, which sits at the bottom of Stawell's gold mine.
Going down a nice shallow grade, and we have a 1,000 meters in depth, but you don't do that in one go. That's called falling. We're gonna have a little road trip with pretty consistent views.
We've hit rush hour down the mine site.
363 heading down.
Look at the size of that thing.
We have to go underground because the rock above us shields the dark matter detector from all the sun's radiation and the cosmic particles from space.
Fittingly, we're going to one of the darkest places on Earth to find dark matter. Going underground is a little weird for an astronomer, though. We tend to like to see the sky. You're going to see history as we go down to the bottom of this site for what will hopefully be the future of search for dark matter.
You can really feel the temperature right now. It is dusty, it is humid. You can tell you are in an active gold mine, and building the cleanest underground laboratory in one of the dirtiest environments seems like a kind of a crazy idea.
The lab is impressive in scale, at 12 meters high.
Look at the size of this thing.
As well as the natural shielding, every single piece in the construction has been specially made and screened for any radiation that might interfere.
I can't wait to get down here and find that dark matter. We have been working for years on this. To see, finally, the underground lab, oh, this is incredible.
Associate Professor Phil Urquhart is a leading experimental particle physicist who will be working here when it opens next year.
It's the deepest underground laboratory in Australia, the first deep underground one that we've ever had, and it's absolutely unique, not only for the search for dark matter, which is sort of the flagship purpose. There are many other applications that we can pursue.
How are the scientists going to find dark matter down here?
We're building the SABR experiment. The main principle of SABR is that when dark matter passes through, occasionally it will interact with the crystal, and when it does, it will emit light.
And then you get the Nobel Prize?
I think so.
Really? Yeah. I don't think you've got to say that.
And that tiny speck of light will allow us to finally see what dark matter actually is. We hope.
So it doesn't generally emit light, but from what he was just saying there, it can under certain circumstances.
Well, it's phenomenal. It's amazing. And I wish I understood any of it.
I'm actually really glad he went to peak there.
All I know is I'm pretty sure the next Thor movie is going to be set in that laboratory. I mean, that is incredible. Alan Duffy is a kid in a candy store.
Oh, I love it.
In that bit. The look on his face was incredible. But, yeah, it's complex.
Well, apparently it makes up 30% of the universe's matter, but how do they even know that?
Oh, well, I'm glad you asked. How long have we got?
Can you ask rhetorical questions from that one, please, PBO?
Well, we can just say yes or no.
All right, why don't we just move on? The Stawell Underground Physics Laboratory will be up and running next year.